Vinnie Jones was in midfield. Let's see how they got on with their former international Brian Flynn and Ian Gwyn Hughes.
It's difficult really to believe that this pitch yesterday, this time last night, was under 3 or 4 inches of snow. Many felt that the game would be in doubt, but the Bulgarians' experience with these sort of conditions. An early touch for Mihailov, yeah, and the shot comes in and it's chipped away. An unexpected opportunity for Dean Saunders, but well, there was a foul. It didn't seem to be too much of a touch on Mihailov, but I can't really understand that decision by the referee. Where the free kick is taken from now, there was no challenge at all. The player slipped, the goalkeeper's actually dropped the ball, and Dean's moves a sharp onto it, and luckily for the defender, he's got a deflection on it. I can't see where the free kick has come from. Sakanov. And towards Penev. Seems to jump at Kit Simons, given away. Lechkov. Kostadinov in the middle. Lechkov calling for the ball, went for the shot himself. Lechkov screaming for the ball, but Stoichkov ignored him. Never really going to trouble Neville Southall, always going over the bar.
Yes, as soon as he's cutting on his right hand side, I looked at Neville's position, and his positioning was absolutely superb, and for him to beat him on the right hand side there would have taken something exceptional. And as soon as Neville seen the flight of it, he knew it was over.
Southall's kick, pressure back on Wales. Simons thought about heading the ball, eventually conceded the throw. Stoichkov to take it. Balakov to Stoichkov. Balakov trying to create space for the shot, and that's a goal. An excellent sight. It would have to be to beat Neville Southall from there, but completely unexpected. The first time really in the first half that they've gone for an effort like that from distance. It was a difficult angle, but he created the space for himself, and Neville Southall had no chance. And with 8 minutes to go until the interval, that's a blow for Wales. It's Bulgaria 1, Wales 0. A misunderstanding. Suddenly Bulgaria have a bit more confidence, and it drops this time to Penev. So it's made the ball back, and it very nearly came into the goal of Vinnie Jones, and Neville Southall had to be alert. The whole complex of this game suddenly has changed. One mistake, and Wales very nearly punished.
Yes, and that was the way our luck is at the moment. It was a deflection into the path of the Bulgarian player. We're under pressure at the moment. We've got to withstand this sort of pressure. We've got to stay in the game.
Wales have a number of players forward as the free kick comes in from chance. This chance here, Mikhailov saves from Saunders, and it's a corner. But that was an opportunity, and it came really from nothing.
Well, it was a free kick, a great free kick in, and Bulgaria were all at sea regarding their offside tactic. Some people stayed. There's a good header back, I think, by John Hartson, and Dean Saunders was on for the rebound. The keeper's made an excellent save from Dean Saunders.
It's hooked away again. At this level, maybe, Brian, you have to take advantage.
Yes, that was the best chance of the game, and the keeper's made an exceptional save. If we could have scored one then it was a whole new ball game. It would have given the lads a little bit more impetus, given them fresh legs, would have kept us going a little bit longer.
Bulgaria comes searching for a second. Balakov has scored the first. The fine layback for Kostadina. Wales are appealing for offside, but the linesman didn't lift his flag, and Wales find themselves 2-0 down.
Well, he looks offside. If you look at the run of Mark Bowen now on the left-hand side, he's followed the ball in, and he's on the 6-yard line. It's level, it's very tight, it's difficult to see, very difficult.
John Hansen has battled away gamely throughout the game. Quite often by himself.
Yes, I think John will be pleased with the way that he's played today. in terms of chances, we haven't been able to create any for him. But I think he'll be quite pleased with the way that he's played today. Being at his first cap, I think he will have many, many more.
Certainly been an exciting few months for him. Move from Luton to Arsenal, European football. As they will get into the third. And Penneth was unmarked really. And Southall had no chance. And I suppose you have to say that was poor defending. But Penneth rose really unchallenged. Did well though, just to lift the ball over Southall, the Welsh defence. They'll be looking at each other there and asking, well, where were we?
I think, well, you've got to put that one down to his lack of just concentration. I think that possibly will come through tiredness. It's late on in the game, we're 2-0 down. They are controlling the game, and basically lack of concentration inside the penalty box. I don't like to say it, but it does happen. That's not an excuse, I'm not defending anyone. It does happen. When you put so much in the game, you just do switch off.
Giggs. Final ball.
Shot
is in and it's there! Dean Saunders has pulled one back. And what a pity that didn't happen 3 minutes ago.
Yeah, very much so. I'm pleased for the lads they've gone on the score sheet, because I think a 3-0 defeat would have been unkind to us. It would have been unfair. It would have been cruel. I'm glad we've got something out of it now. I'm glad we've got a goal. Just to give the lad that little bit of a boost.
And Dean Saunders just took a swing at it with his left foot, and Mikhailov had no chance. That's his 15th goal for Wales. And it was created Ryan Giggs' fine dribble across the field. Two players missed the ball, and he just struck to Dean Saunders. And first time.
Excellent finish. He's hit the target, and that's the most important thing.
And that's the final whistle. Bulgaria have won here in Sofia by 3-1. Far better Welsh performance, we have to emphasise that. But they were beaten by a fine goal in the first half by Balakov. Further goals were added in the second half by Penneth, with both really, although I'm sure Kostadinov will claim the second. Dean Saunders restored a bit of Welsh pride, as did the performance in general.
Well, I'm a little bit disappointed because...